With just 5 days to go before the new year, Filipinos are expected to troop to Bocaue, Bulacan, known as the fireworks capital of the Philippines. Authorities now busy ensuring pyrotechnic stores there are implementing safety standards. Zian Ambrosio now joins us with the latest from there. Zian, over to you.
Casey, I have with me here a fire extinguisher ball. This is one of the requirements of the Bureau of Fire Protection and the inspection teams in order to get a fire safety inspection certificate. This fire extinguisher ball says that as long as it has been touched for 3 to 5 seconds by flame reaching 70 degrees centigrade, it will automatically extinguish the fire effectively and rapidly. Inspection teams coming from the Bureau of Fire Department, Business Processing and Licensing Office, or BPLO, Sanitary Department of the LGU, Department of Trade and Industry, or DTI, and the PNP visited and inspected several fireworks stores here in Bocaue, Bulacan. The officials checked each store if they are complying with the requirements set by the Bureau of Fire Protection and the LGU. One of which is at least 1 meter distance of the fireworks from the ceiling, since the heat coming from the sun may possibly cause heat transfer to the chemicals of the fireworks. There should be fire extinguishers and smoke detectors present in their stores. The roof should be leak-proof, since some chemicals that get wet can easily explode. Inspection started since last month, and almost all of the stores are complying with it, with all the requirements according to the Bureau of Fire Protection. And that's the latest here in Bocaue, Bulacan. Casey?
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosio. A flight to Osamis City was canceled due to bad weather, leaving its passengers stranded at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Jervis Manaha now joins us with details. Jervis, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, dozens of passengers were stranded after the flight to Osamis City in Misamis Occidental was canceled due to bad weather. The flight took off at around 5 in the morning, but an hour mid-flight, the pilot announced that the aircraft will be unable to land safely because of heavy rains. So the aircraft diverted back to Manila. The passengers were offered refunds, rebooking, or rerouting. But the flight to Osamis tomorrow is already fully booked. So they have the option to divert to other nearby cities like Pagadian and Dipolog or refund the payment of their ticket. We have talked to some passengers here who are en route to Osamis. Some said they are going there for vacation, some for work, and one is even attending her dad's funeral. According to residents of Misamis Occidental, the flood has subsided but the rains began pouring again early this morning. We have talked to one resident in Aloran, Misamis Occidental, and she said there is still no water and power supply in their area. Misamis Occidental is already under the state of calamity due to heavy flooding. Thousands of families are in evacuation centers because of flooding that started on Christmas Day. Hermina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manahan. They're joining us on the line. Back here in the newsroom, a rainfall warning still up over parts of the Visayas. Let's get more details now from PAGASA weather forecaster Rhea Torres. Rhea, over to you.
Yes, good morning to you as well, Ms. Carmina. As of the moment, the shear line will be continuing to bring rains, moderate to heavy rains, with at times intense rains over eastern Visayas. Meanwhile, moderate to at times heavy rains is expected over Palawan, Bohol, Zamboanga Peninsula, northern Mindanao, as well as Caraga. Therefore, citizens are warned against possible flooding and rain-induced landslides due to the effects of shear line. Meanwhile, here in Luzon, the northeast monsoon will be continuing to prevail and affect most of Luzon and will be bringing cloudy skies with rains over Cagayan Valley, Cordillera, Aurora, Quezon, and in Bicol region. Meanwhile, for Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, may expect partly cloudy to cloudy skies with light rains due to the effects of northeast monsoon. And due to, as of the moment, we still have a gale warning raised over the seaboards of Luzon, Visayas, and eastern seaboard of Mindanao. Therefore, fishing boats and other small sea crafts are still advised not to venture out into sea while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. And right now, we're not monitoring any low-pressure area or a tropical cyclone within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, the shear line will be continuing to prevail over most of Visayas and Mindanao area until tomorrow, and possibly by Thursday, we may be experiencing improving weather conditions until the coming new year. Meanwhile, here in Luzon, Carmina, we will still be continuing to experience the effects of the northeast monsoon over most of Luzon for the coming days. And that's the latest here from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thanks a lot, Rhea. To you and the rest of the team there, thanks again, and we appreciate all that you do.